Who am I speaking to?
You're speaking to Bob Norp. I'm the host of the Beancast and Ad Age Outlook.
Hey, and I have been on your show a couple of times, and I've actually offered you, or I've not offered, asked for you to somebody to kill somebody because you said you would kill somebody if I was on your show.
I said I would kill someone if I could get you on the show, and I have not honored that commitment in any way, shape, or form, so.
Yeah, and I've been on the show twice, so I'm expecting two people dead. No, but here's my thing. You said you're frustrated with something with regards to brand advocacy. What's that?
Well, my number one complaint with brand advocacy is the fact that we think that we can reduce it down to a set of metrics, that we think if we can put together an algorithm, the right algorithm, we can figure out who the influencers are and that we can suddenly create this huge advocacy wave. And really, advocacy comes from the heart. It comes from actually knowing what a person is thinking and knowing what they care about, connecting with the things that they care about. I mean, just because someone ranks very high on a clout score doesn't necessarily make them an advocate for your brand. All that does is make them a statistical anomaly.
Right. Well, that actually, that's, you know, a lot of people confuse the difference between influencer and advocate. And what that might be is an influencer, but that definitely doesn't determine that person's an advocate. I mean, we all can be advocates.
Well, and that's the thing. I mean, we're mixing terms here. I mean, it's just like people automatically assume that the clout score means that this person is an advocate. It doesn't even mean that they're an influencer, let alone an advocate. All it does is gives us a hint that maybe this person is connecting with our brand in some way, and maybe we should investigate a little further, and maybe we should overlay some additional data from other sources onto that and figure out exactly what's going on there. And then maybe we should delve into the community and actually interact with people and find out, is this advocacy real? Is it genuine? Is this person somebody who I need to target? Are they an influencer within their community, and can they spur more advocacy within the community? Quite frankly, I mean, it's just like we may find that there are levels of advocacy even beyond them that are not connecting online, that are maybe a completely in an offline venue. You know, it's just like, and they're being spurred on by those advocates. And, you know, you don't find these things unless you actually delve into a community and find out what's going on.
Very good point. Hey, and I actually interviewed Joe from Cloud, who's the CEO, and he claims that, well, the cloud score isn't supposed to be the end-all, be-all. It's sort of the beginning point where you dig down deeper to find out more. Well, my attitude is, yeah, you might be saying that, but everyone's taking it the other way.
And, you know, I don't mean to slam clout. I mean, they've risen to be the highest profile measure of influencers and advocacy out there. I think it's a good start. It's a good metric that can be used appropriately. Unfortunately, it's being used inappropriately. And, you know, quite God bless clout. They're not going to tell you that you're using it wrong. They're going to take your money and quite frankly, do an influencer program with you. So, I mean, you know, I can't blame them for that. But the fact is, all these metrics that are trying to, all these tools that are out there are trying to give us a sense for who the true advocates are. They're only giving us, you know, I've heard some analysts that I've talked to say they're giving us about 60% accuracy. And there's no way to replace that other than going in and actually interacting with people and having a true relationship with them and understand how they actually feel about your brand. Getting firsthand reactions from your customers.
And that is actually what Zuberance does. So you'll learn more about that tonight. Hey, thanks so much for your time, Bob.
You're welcome. I'm glad I fed into your PR talking points.